and Jake, I think our founding fathers are probably rolling in their graves right now. They did not envision a president of the United States delegitimizing an American election, and that is what the president just did a few moments ago. It's historic, and it's historically awful. I think one of the things that we're going to have to wait and see over the next several days is, and they've been previewing this over at the White House and inside the Trump campaign, they're going to be deploying, if they have not already deployed, an army of lawyers to all of these states where they want to contest the results of the election to try to cast aside votes that are still being counted. They want to question the legitimacy of these timelines for counting ballots in states where ballots are coming in after Election Day. The president, it does not compute with the president that states are allowed to have varying ways of counting votes. That is one of the traditions of our democracy, that states sort of run their own affairs when it comes to counting votes. And the president does not get that. We did hear Vice President Mike Pence, as Abby was saying a few moments ago, get up to the podium and contradict the president almost immediately and say that the votes continue to be counted. So there was at least an ounce of decency in that room when Vice President Pence came up there. He's obviously not going to tell the president to his face that he's wrong, but if you read between the lines, he was essentially allowing for the fact that votes are going to continue to be counted, Jake.
All right, Jim Acosta, thanks so much. Let's bring in...